Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video I want to go over how you might create an image map for your web page. So an image map allows you to insert one image on a page and then create different shaped hotspots or clickable zones. So a user could click on a particular shape or area and they'd be taken to a different web page. I'll give you an example of that over here. On this Florida, it looks like a nursing website, they've got the state of Florida broken up into multiple regions, groups of counties, and each individual shape or each individual group here is a separate hyperlink leading to another web page. We're going to do something similar, but a lot simpler, just so you can get the basics down. So the shape I'm using is just got our basic square, rectangle, circle, and a triangle, which I'm going to use as a polygon. And these are the three basic shapes you can create with an image map. Let's check out the code. So I've got a generic page set up, just a headline, and I've got my image on there. And I've already got the very important useMap attribute. So the useMap attribute goes inside of the image tag, and it's going to refer to a section of your page which will contain map code. I haven't created that yet though. So I've got useMap equals pound sign or hashtag shapes. And you can call this anything you want, just no spaces and don't start with a number. Now for the map code, this can be anywhere on your page. I'll go ahead and put it right beneath my image though. My map code is going to be identified with a name attribute, and I need to make sure I use the same name that I referred to with the useMap attribute. And I'm also going to go ahead and put an ID attribute in here for good practice. So my browser is going to understand that this image is going to use map code hashtag shapes, and the map has been named as shapes. So this is where the map code is going to go for this particular image. So you can have multiple image maps on the same web page as long as they use different map codes. Now within my map tags, I'm going to have three area tags, and the area tag has a few important attributes. The shape attribute identifies the shape that we're going to be using. The chords attribute identifies the coordinates that define the shape. The href attribute, of course, will contain the file name or the web address, the URL, that's where the user is going to go when they click on the shape. And of course, our alt attribute, just like in an image, is alternate text for vision impaired. It's also a good attribute to include here. I'll go ahead and duplicate this a few times. And for my hyper-references, I'll just put in few generic URLs. Okay, now the first shape I'll work with is rect for rectangle. Then I'll do the circle, and then I'll do poly for polygon. Now the rectangle is going to be probably one of the most common ones, and it's pretty easy to do. The coordinates you're going to need are the top left corner and the bottom right corner. Now, on my image editor, I'm using Pixlr, which is just a web-based image editor. And by the way, any image editor will allow you to get coordinates. On here, I just look over to the right side and I can see the XY for wherever my point is. So I put my point on the top left corner of the rectangle, and I see that it's about 43:39. So on my code, I'm going to type in 43, 39, and I'll go into another comma because I'm going to need the bottom right coordinates now, which I see are 222, 222. There we go. So those are the coordinates for my rectangle shape, and I've got enough to test. I save my web page, go to my browser, refresh my web page there, and you'll notice the entire image is not a link, but once I get over to that square, that rectangle shape, it is a hyperlink, and if I click it, it will take me to Yahoo. All right, now for the circle, you need to find the center point of the circle, and then you need to determine the radius. So on my image editor, I'll put my point, I'm just going to eyeball this where I think the center point might be. Looks like 372, 127. 372, 127, now I need to figure out the radius. So if I roughly in the center again, move my pointer to the right edge, I see my center point X was 372, now I'm about 471, that's roughly 99 or 100 pixels for the coordinates. So I'll just go ahead and type in 100 for my radius, save that. And let me go ahead and take care of the polygon shape. Now I chose a triangle because it was going to be the simplest for me to demonstrate, but you can do a poly shape with anything, and for that matter, a rectangle. But you'll need a set of coordinates for every change in direction, for every point. Okay, so since I've got a triangle, I'll need three sets of coordinates. Now it doesn't matter where you start, but so I'll start up here in the top, and I see my coordinates are 135, 274. Then bottom right coordinates, 226, 441. And bottom left coordinates, 439. Actually, I could do 441 again, so that way I know I'm on that same horizontal. So now I've got three sets of coordinates for my polygon. I've got one set of coordinates for my circle, and then I've got the radius as that third value. And of course, my rectangle shape has two sets of XY coordinates. Go ahead and save this back over to my browser, refresh the page, and of course, my rectangle works. There's my circle, which takes me over to Bing. And now my triangle or my polygon takes me to Google. Alright, so that's the basics for creating an image map. Not too tough, and it does come in handy in those situations when you want to have an image on your page that has clickable hotspots or clickable areas on it.